In this video, I'm going to be sharing fully funded scholarships for international students, okay? A fully funded scholarship means that your tuition fee, your living expenses, your flight ticket is going to be taken care of. So all you need to do is just go to school and study. I understand that there are so many scholarships out there that I cannot exhaust, but because I love you and I don't want you to be stressed, I painstakingly selected fully funded scholarships for you. My job here is to direct you and to just tell you that so and so scholarship exists. So because I'm going to leave the links, their websites in the description box, I expect that if you're really interested in getting funding, you would visit this website and get first-hand information for yourself. Mind you, the application windows for some of these scholarships are already open, so you should take advantage, okay? Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're doing great. And if this is your first time on my channel, my name is Kuseme Ise. You can call me Kuskus. And on this channel, I share insights on education, career advancement, and personal development, as well as fun. So on today's video, I'm going to be sharing different fully funded scholarships for international students for postgraduate studies abroad. I've been making a couple of videos about what you need to secure postgraduate, postgraduate funding, how you need to get into postgraduate schools. And a lot of people have been asking me, I should share information on different scholarships. And that is why I came up with this video. I've been able to compile lots and lots of scholarships for international students that are fully funded for your postgraduate studies. I'm not going to be able to exhaust all of them in this video, so I'm going to divide it into two. On today's video, I'm just going to share fully funded scholarships for international students for their postgraduate studies, basically in Europe. So if you are interested in getting funding for your postgraduate studies, you definitely do need to keep watching this video. And if you're yet to subscribe to this channel, what are you waiting for? This is the time to actually subscribe to this channel so that you will not miss all the insightful information that I share on this channel. Okay, let me just give out a disclaimer. Whatever information I share here are my personal views and not that of any other organization. So please, whatever information you get from here, all you need to do is to go to their website and get the direct information from their website. So the first one is the Chevening Scholarship. The Chevening Scholarship is a fully funded scholarship that is funded by the Foreign and Commonwealth Office with contributions from UK universities and private organizations and other government bodies. So the Chevening Scholarship sponsors about 1,500 postgraduate students from developing countries for their postgraduate degrees in the UK university. So if you are from a developing country and you want to study in the UK, the Chevening Scholarship is for you. Because the eligibility requirements, you need to come from a developing country, you need to have at least 2 years working experience. Okay, so for you to have 2 years work experience, you need to work for at least 40 hours a week for 52 weeks in a year for you to have 1 year work experience. So you have to double that to have 2 years work experience. You can always use your NYSC experience, your volunteering experience, just compile and document everything. And once you meet that requirement, then you know that you have 2 years work experience. You need to be able to demonstrate leadership capacity. This is one of the most important eligibility requirements for the Chevening Scholarship. You need to be able to demonstrate leadership capacity, that you can be able, that you are able to solve problems in your immediate environment, and you need to be able to show what you've done so far and what you're going to do when you're back from your postgraduate studies. And you need to apply to at least three universities in the UK and get admission from at least one. Another condition is that you must return to your country for at least 2 years after your study. So when you are done with your postgraduate studies, the requirement is that you come back to your country. If you are from Nigeria, you will come back to Nigeria and stay in Nigeria for at least 2 years before you leave Nigeria again. The rationale is because they are sponsoring you to go and get expert knowledge for you to come back and develop your country, so that you will come back and implement all the ideas, all the things that you have learned during your postgraduate studies, you come back and implement it. The application opens before now, usually opens between August and November, but this year the application is going to open from 3rd September 2020, and this is for postgraduate studies, or those that want to go for their postgraduate studies in 2021. That's between 3rd September and November, usually around first week of November. The application is done online on the Chivening website. The entire application is an online process. You go online, you fill the application forms. It has different essays that you have to answer, you know, and all of that. That's basically it. So you, they are not going to tell you, take this form and go and give your Paramount ruler to fill. It's an online application. So guys, I encourage you to take advantage of the Chivening scholarship application that is going to open on the 3rd September 2020 for all those who want to go for their postgraduate studies in 2021. So I'm going to leave the link to the Chivening website at the description, you know, description box, so that you can visit their website and you know, get to read about them and have a complete knowledge of what the Chivening scholarship is about. Let's go straight to the second one. So the second scholarship is the Commonwealth scholarship. The Commonwealth scholarship is funded by the UK Department for International Development. That is DFID. So the Commonwealth scholarships are two types. We have the Commonwealth Shared and then we have the Commonwealth Masters. The only difference is actually the nominating agency. So for the Commonwealth Masters, the nominating agency for Nigerians is the Federal Scholarship Board. So for any other country, any other developing or Commonwealth country, it's going to be the scholarship board for your country that will nominate you. And then for the Commonwealth Shared, the nominating agency is a partner university. Commonwealth scholarship sponsors about 800 postgraduate students every year, and you need to do a full-time master's degree which is not more than 12 months. You need to choose a postgraduate program that is 12 months or less and not more, because it will not be eligible. For the eligibility requirements, you need to be a citizen and a permanent resident of an eligible Commonwealth country. If you are from Nigeria and you live here, you are qualified. So if you are from other countries, you need to go to the website and check if your country is eligible. So one of the most important eligibility requirements for the Commonwealth Scholarship is for you to demonstrate development impact capability. So the Commonwealth has different development core areas for different Commonwealth countries. So for you to be able to be awarded a Commonwealth Scholarship, you should be able to demonstrate in your essays that you have the capacity to contribute to either of their development impact areas. So the application opens, I don't know the exact date, because you know that due to COVID-19, there are so many slight changes everywhere, but just look between July, September, August, Commonwealth Scholarship is going to open. I know that the Commonwealth Masters application window closes before that of the Shared. The Shared takes up to December. If you want to apply for Commonwealth Scholarship, you need to be monitoring their website, because you're going to be notified when the application window starts and when it ends, so that it will inform how you plan your application. Like I said, I'm going to drop the link to where you can read all about the Commonwealth Scholarship. I'm going to drop it in the description box. And yeah, but Commonwealth Scholarship is what you should, you know, just take the opportunity and apply. You will not regret it. Let me not advertise for Commonwealth. Let me go straight to the next opportunity. The next scholarship is the DAD scholarship. So DAD is an acronym for a German establishment. The DAD scholarship is funded by the German government for international students to study in Germany. Like, it sponsors over 100,000 students each year. It is like the largest funding organization worldwide. You don't need to come from a developing country. You don't need to come from a Commonwealth country. Just be able to demonstrate that you are driven to cause a change in your field. That's it though. Hey guys. In fact, the DAD scholarship sponsors you for up to 2 years master's degree and 4 years PhD. Like, could you imagine? In all fields. And you have to actually study in Germany. For the eligibility, you need a good bachelor's degree, at least 2 years work experience. You have to be driven to cause a change in your field. And to take up this scholarship, you need not later than 6 years of last academic studies. So you need to apply like within 6 years after your first degree if you're going for master's, and within 6 years after your master's if you're going for your PhD. Just watch out for the window and make sure that you meet that criteria. And so the application window varies depending on the school that you want to apply. I'm going to leave their website so that when you go to their website, you're going to read and, you know, find out as much information as you need. Just be rest assured that it is fully funded, and it is for German institutions. The next scholarship is Erasmus Mundus Scholarship. It is funded by the European Union and managed by the Education, Audiovisual and Cultural Executive Agency. That is the EACEA. So the Erasmus Mundus Scholarship is for full-time master's degree to study in schools in the program of your choice, like different programs, different schools, and you can actually take up master's program that between 1 year and 2 years. The program is such that you can learn, you can go to different countries within Europe and you learn from different universities as the case may be. Erasmus Mundus Scholarship is well sought after. If I were you, and if you want to really explore Europe apart from just learning, I would advise you to take up this opportunity because it is not such that you would miss. The eligibility requirement differs per course. It is for full-time postgraduate studies, and you know, so you must apply to one of the Erasmus Mundus joint master's degree. They have an organization where most of the schools are members, so you when you visit their websites, you understand what I mean. So you have to apply to those schools and to get the admission before you're qualified for the scholarship. The application window opens between November and December depending on the school, and some of them last till January, March of the following year. So look out from October, November this year, or even if I were you, I'll go to their website now to start monitoring when the application is going to open. And so the application is done by applying to one of the schools that I have already said. Yeah, and I'm going to leave their website so that you can go and get much more information on Erasmus Mundus Scholarship. Guys, this scholarship is one of the most sought after scholarships in the world. Guys, please take this opportunity. Okay, so I don't want this video to be so long. Like I said already, I have other scholarships I'm going to share in this channel in my next video. Before I share the next one, I would expect that you must have gone to their website, you must have visited their website to explore all the scholarships and identify the one that best suits what you want. I hope you've learned something from this channel. I hope you've learned something from this video today. And if you know some other scholarships that I haven't mentioned, you can as well share it in the comment section so that you help other people. You can as well drop the link also so that you also help viewers. If you have any questions, drop it in the comment section. If you have any video suggestion, you can also drop it in the comment section, and I will do that just for you. Also, like this video if it has been of help to you. Share it to all the people you know that this video will help. If you need postgraduate funding, you need to stay hooked to this channel, because I'm going to bring in more funding opportunities in my next videos. If you are yet to subscribe to this channel, now is the time to do that, because you don't want to miss subsequent videos. And when you do subscribe, kindly do well to ring the notification bell so that when I post, you would be aware. Also, follow me on social media. My Instagram is IamCusCus. There I actually do real-time interaction, not like YouTube that I come here once a week. And stay tuned to this channel. Don't forget that my video comes up every Friday at noon, and sometimes I also post vlogs, which comes on Sundays at 2 p.m. Nigerian time, Central African time. So do well to keep watching other videos of mine, and I'll catch you in my next video. Take care of yourself. Bye. You must apply and be admitted to one of the Erasmus Mundus joint modules in the program for the okay.